teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Golden Bears and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. And when you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line.
Here we go. Black, nine, cut.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. And they make the stop around the 47-yard line. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, it's a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
He's on the run.
Hey, sometimes the defense does everything right, and they still lose. That time they had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the quarterback to take off.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45.
Ready!
And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Somebody jumped early down there.
False start, offense.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a five-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
From the 49-yard line, it's second down. Nothing gained on the play.
This young wide receiver has the raw ability to make some big plays. So that was a good job there by the defense to stop him for a short game.
He's going to go for the home run. The defender had it and then dropped it. Nice play by the defense to bring up fourth down.
The defender made a solid effort to get to the ball there. Nice stop.
They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Good job by the defense to force a punt on the first series.
Boy, the crowd was loud and did their part. Now if they're able to move the ball downfield, they can take control of this game early.
The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. And he hits him hard at the 12-yard line.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. He found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long.
Watch two.
Quick throw, almost intercepted.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance, but that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
Four down. Mike one.
Down. Two, seven. Watch the motion.
Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
Number two, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and long.
Certainly they don't have the return on here. And this one is a beauty. He's taken down at the 47. Notre Dame's defense got the stop they wanted on that first drive. Now let's see if they can do it again.
And just listen to this crowd, Brad. I mean, you can practically feel the energy coming down from the crowd and how it's impacting these players.
Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Nice gain as he works the right side. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Here we go.
sack for a loss. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 43. Complete. He's got space to work. He steps out right around the 46-yard line. And this is what power football is all about, folks. He's tackled around the 49-yard line. Defense stiffens there and gives it back to their offense.
Well, the offense looked like they wanted to bounce the ball to the outside. This defense just has too much speed. Did a good job of shutting off the edge and preventing the ball carrier from getting to the first down.
Quick throw, and he's hit immediately. Inside give.
The defense was able to get really good penetration and drop him short of the line of scrimmage.
That brings up third and 12.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 28.
Roger, Roger. Mike one, Mike one.
The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. It's going to be fourth and inches after that long pickup on third down.
Boy, what a throw by the quarterback. Almost equally excellent catch by the receiver, but the defense topped them both by coming up with a stop.
Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. Not quite enough for the first. Looks like they'll turn it over on downs.
You know what? I think they still made the right call there.
I can't argue the play call. The defense just did their job by standing their ground. They went for it on fourth down on their last possession and weren't successful.
Hey, Brad, remember the last time this offense came out of the field? Of course, they went for it on fourth down. Sometimes it drives me crazy when we call all of these games and these guys out here go for it all the time on fourth down. Here's a message. If it's longer than fourth and five, just consider a field goal or a punt.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. He's at midfield, fires out to his wideout, and down he goes at the 44-yard line. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Safety showed it there by pouncing on the football.
And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. And he's taken down at the 47-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that.
No good in the play. That makes it second and 10.
Check three, check three, check three.
We've played one. Now this one's scoreless. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter.
Solo out there. Check the outs out there.
Three down. Three down.
Three down. Three down.
Here we go.
Oh. Back down.
Get to that quickly. Tackle made at about the 35. There was some movement on the line.
False start. Offense.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
Still first down.
So the penalty makes it first and 15.
Four down. Mike one.
Get down. Yellow 90.
The back gets three on the carry.
There's the junior cornerback making a very solid stop. Anytime your corners can contribute like that against the run, it gives your defense another advantage.
Here's the halfback on the screen. They'll bring him down at the 30. 7 yards there.
He executed the screen play well here by getting the ball to the halfback to pick up some yards.
At the 19-yard line.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Brought down right around the 20. Tackled at the 10-yard line. Tailback picks up a good-looking 10 yards on the draw. Now he tries to buy some time. He's going to run it. He's only got one guy in his way. Hits the PAT. A 10-play, 67-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling in that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. He goes out of bounds at the 34-yard line. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. It's the sophomore that's got it, and he's level at the 40.
That makes it first and 10.
Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike to 59. Let's go.
He might not be able to get the pass off. They bring him down.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
From their own 38-yard line. Second down. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers.
Easy. Delta. High.
Out of bounds, around the 43-yard line.
That makes it 37.
The ball. Now the defense has it. The safety. He's taken down at the 48. pretty big mistake, and this offense will lose possession of the football.
Sloppy job by the ball carrier. First and foremost, you should always be concerned about the ball.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Notre Dame is up a score.
He might have a chance. He makes his way to about the 42.
Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Incomplete, and that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. There's a strike complete. He's down. So they turn it over on downs, and that's a big boost for this defense.
In a close game like this one, it's big plays like this that can be the deciding factor.
Misfortune struck as their last drive ended in a fumble.
Sometimes when you lose the football, you start to focus a little bit more. So a turnover can actually work out in your favor.
Throws and it's incomplete.
You know, for you young cornerbacks and young defensive backs, this is a great example of just being smart and efficient as a defender. Instead of taking a chance and going for that interception, he was smart, got in position, knocked the football away, and did give the receiver a chance to make a play on the football.
From their own 34-yard line, third down. They come out in a five-wide set. And they make the stop at about the 47-yard line. That's a gain of 13 on the play.
First down. Reset, tight leg. Check 59. Mike is 59. Let's go. Guys, 48.
He's out of bounds at about the 49. Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 49-yard line.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, we're going to mic
the... Throws this one out to the left. Caught sideline, and he stays in.
That makes it first and 10.
At the 10. What a throw for a big gain.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Here we go. Hot, hot. Red 68.
Makes the grab and out of bounds. So the completion goes for about 5 yards and a first down.
The blitzer's coming in fast, but the quarterback stood his ground, found his receiver, and moved the chains.
Throws it, and it's tipped away. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. And he throws it away. It's 3rd and goal from the 5. Let's see if they can put this one in. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Scrambling around. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. No one could break clear, so the QB decided to run it in.
You've got to like it when your leader takes things into his own hands, especially inside the 10.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Oh, really a defensive battle going on right now so far, Kirk.
Well, the defenses are flying around the football, doing a good job. I think both offenses are making it a little easier because of their style of game plan. I think the offensive coordinator, take a few chances. Be willing to open it up and try to give your quarterback a chance to make a play.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
Throws out to the back, and it's through his hands. From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Passes to the wideout, and he can't pull it in.
Number seven, our intended receiver on the play. That brings us third and 10.
Decent run here, right side. That's a nice run, but it's short of the first down.
Good play by the defense to stop him just short.
Booming kick. Tackle made at the 28-yard line. Sure, that touchdown on their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, and you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
Got hit and still completed it. And down he goes at the 44.
That's good for a game of 16 yards. First down.
Red 85! Red!
Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked.
That'll make it second and long.
He's wrapped up for the sack. They've been all over this quarterback today.
The pass protection has got to do a better job, but give this defense some credit. They've really figured out what they have to do to pressure the quarterback and to cause him some problems.
Notre Dame's going to have to use their second time out of the half. So they run the ball on third and long, and it's stopped.
Well, Brad, here the offense is trying to surprise the defense with a run, but it didn't work.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. I guess he'll throw this one as far as he can and hope for a miracle. He airs it out. Incomplete. So at the end of the half, we get a tie game at 7-7.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Defense has been dominant in this game. Yards very hard to come by. But David, as we get deeper and deeper into this game, the natural assumption is that the pressure goes to the offense to do something. How much pressure is on the defense not to make that catastrophic mistake?
Well, that's the conundrum you get in. I mean, it makes it exceptionally tough because you want to play perfect and you want to get them to punt every single time, but it's not the way it works. And it's those big plays that you usually see that kill the defenses and break their backs. And you can hold them great, Reese, on first down, second down, it's third and long. You're in a perfect situation. You give up that one play for 80, and it changes the whole complexion of the game. So I think you got to have a little bit of both. It can't just be great defense the whole time. Usually the teams that play great defense can keep you in it, but only for so long. At some point, that offense has to get something going.
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm going to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
All
All right, guys, welcome back. Second half just about set to start, and we're dead even.
He sends this one deep. And they can forget about returning this one.
A lot of times you'll see teams start to clench up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time.
Just throws this one away.
Second down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on their own 25.
Run to the left there.
That's a deep throw.
Four down.
That'll be number 36.
Mike Wood.
And he's taken down at the 35-yard line. Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. From their own 35-yard line, second down. He's got it out to his tight end. Tackle made at the 42.
Defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
Fourth down.
He puts it away, and it's a great kick.
He takes it at the 12.
He's tackled at the 21-yard line.
We're taking a look at a seasoned defender logging another huge effort.
Well, he's just one of those defensive players that if you're an offensive coordinator, you're basically building your game plan around his skills. And I'll tell you, the other thing that's unique is the offense seems to be spending so much time with him that it's freeing up the other defenders to be able to come in and also help him out in making plays.
In a game this tightly contested, it comes down to which defense is playing better. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count.
Draw play. They'll drop him for a loss.
Loss of two on the run by the halfback.
And I'll tell you what, not only was this great penetration, but it was a heck of a hit, too.
Second and 11 coming up now.
Ball on the 19-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. He steps out at the 22. He unloads it. They'll bring him down at the 48-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10. Slings it. That's a great tackle at the 43.
Number six makes the tackle at the 43-yard line. That makes it second and six.
Three down.
Hey, alert 48. Alert 48.
Black, it's the eight. Easy. Sting right on.
Tackle around the 36-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line.
Here we go.
He has some room. Gains his way to the 20-yard line.
Gain of 16 yards. First down.
They'll get him for a loss. He had nowhere to go on that option play.
Boy, you're right. He's lucky he held onto the football there.
So it's second and 14. Ball on the 25-yard line.
Here we go. Wide 88.
Fires that quickly, incomplete. It's the ninth play of the drive. And he's going to be sacked.
As an offensive line, you've got to do a better job as a group at communicating. Defense brought pressure. That time, they did not do a good job of picking up the linebackers. The linebacker was able to come up with a sack.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. California could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is away. It's long enough, and he splits the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Golden Bears continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. Side. And he's tackled around the 49-yard line.
That's a gain of 8 on that play. That makes it second and 2.
Brought down at the 41-yard line. It out to his receiver in a hurry. He's gobbled up in the backfield. That'll be a loss of one.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Third down.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. Fires out to his receiver. He's at the 20. And he's finally shoved out at the 7. Throws it in a hurry. Touchdown, Fighting Irish. Converts the extra point. Notre Dame lines up for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Kirk, you and I like seeing points. We're seeing points in this third quarter. This has been fun.
And I think it's going to continue, Brad. I think the adjustments that were made at halftime have allowed these quarterbacks to go out and really be able to take command of how they want to attack each defense. It's going to come down to that final drive.
They'll
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. They'll get two on that one.
It was a nice catch by the sophomore, but it was well played by the defense to stop him for a minimal gain.
From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He gets rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. And folks, it's neck and neck as we head to the final quarter of play. 14-10, Fighting Irish. Well, this final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Throws complete, and he's hit right away.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch. That's fun to see.
It's second down, six to go. Ball on their own 42.
Mike is 59. Mike to 59.
And he breaks another. And they push him out at the 39. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up five wide. Finds his man and they take him down immediately. So it's fourth down and the offense is still on the field. Throws in the middle. He's taken down at the 46-yard line. And this play is number eight on the drive.
Four down, four down.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, we're going to mic the 48 right now. Let's go. Uh-huh.
He's at the 30. First down grab. And they make the stop at the 27-yard line.
Number 22 on the tackle. 27-yard line. First down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. Pressure coming. He throws left. Off his hands, incomplete.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
That'll bring up third and eight.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 17. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. And he's tackled right away. We're at the 12th play of the drive. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That brings him second and five.
They're at the 6. It's second down. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Don't say nothing.
Let's go!
and he just gets rid of it. This is the 14th play of this drive. To the 20. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. Notre Dame's ranking, that doesn't mean anything right now.
Now, they've not played up to their expectations at all, but they have the football here late in the game. They're very fortunate to still have a chance to maybe win it because they've not looked like themselves.
This is a pretty crucial series right here with things being so tight. Your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. He's out to the 30. He's to the 40. The 50. He's finally tackled at the 33. And he's level at the 44.
Loss of 11 yards on the play. That'll make it second and long.
Just over 2 minutes in the game. Zips it to the back.
That one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Fourth and long here after the sack.
Get down, get down, get down.
He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback.
Brad, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. And he's taken down around the 31-yard line.
Huge first down right there by the offense, Brad. At this point, they're just trying to work the clock and preserve the victory.
After a decent run up the gut, the misdirection play gets him 4 yards. It's second and 6. Ball on their own 35. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Notre Dame's out of timeouts. Makes the catch and look out. And down he goes at the 41.
Well, the idea here was obviously not to try anything tricky or force the ball down the field. A simple throw, and they got the first down that they needed.
Under a minute left in the game.
Here we go. Green, 19. Green.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That'll make it second and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock.
Easy, easy, easy. Fox 2, Fox 2.
Takes a knee.
Too tight, too tight.
And this one's all but wrapped up. The Golden Bears take it here. 17-14. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.